God bless you, viewers. God bless you for today. It is a day that God has made. Welcome to Elohai TV. I want you to subscribe to this channel. Share it to friends and friends. Let them be a blessing. My name is Apostle Alex BOAKYE Anointing, Senior Pastor of Word Christian Ministries. I'm here to be a blessing to you by the Word of God. I thank my sponsors, Elohai TV. God bless them. May God multiply them. May God continue to use them to bring, to be a blessing to this generation. Elohai TV, God bless you. Yeah, this evening, this morning, afternoon, whatever, depending on wherever you are watching me from, I have a very powerful anointed topic for you. This topic is a very controversial one. I believe God used me to be a blessing to you. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I bless your holy name, God, for the privilege to speak your word. Thank you, Father, for the viewers, as many people that are watching me. I pray that you use this word to be a blessing to them. Let your word be written and upon the tablets of your heart. I bind every spirit that will come against this word. In the name of Jesus, let your word have free course in their life. In the name of Jesus, use it to renew their mind and to bless them. In Jesus' precious name, I pray for the necessary grace to be doers of the word. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father, for answering prayer. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Yeah, this evening, my message for you, the title is How to Multiply Your Money. How to Multiply Your Money. How to Multiply Your Money. Very powerful topic. How to multiply your money. Everybody loves money. You see, I always tell people that Christianity is a kingdom. When you are born again, you are born into this kingdom. You are born into this kingdom. And you are born into a kingdom. And every kingdom has this way of doing things. And it's rather unfortunate that so many Christians don't know how the kingdom of God operates. So, on this channel, Elohai TV, I'll be taking you through some of the kingdom house, how to do things in this kingdom. So I'll be treating different topics concerning the principles of this kingdom, how to do things. So tonight is one of the house, how to multiply your money. I'll be teaching how to pray and how to receive answers to your prayer. I'll be teaching you how to put your angels to work, how to receive from God. You see, God and the New Testament has given everything that we need, but we have to receive it. So how do you receive from God? How do you cast out demon? How do you receive healing? How do you maintain healing? How do you prosper? How do you maintain prosperity? How do you marry? How do you maintain marriage? How do you see in the spirit? How do you prophesy? How do you operate in the supernatural? How do you operate in the gift of the spirit? How do you hear from God? How do you overcome the works of your flesh? How do you overcome sexual sins? How do you overcome sexual temptation? How do you work under divine help? How do you work under divine provision? How do you receive direction from God? There are many. You understand? How do you renew your mind? How do you receive the language of the Spirit? So I'll be taking you to all these house. I call it kingdom house or divine house. So tonight, I have for you how to multiply your money. How to multiply your money. How to multiply your money. Why how to multiply your money? You know, in this kingdom, the God that we serve is a God of multiplication. He's a God of multiplication. He's not a God of addition. He's a God of multiplication. So when you check your Bible concordance, you see that the multiplication, you multiply, you see it so many times. God says, I'll multiply you, I'll bless you, I'll multiply your seed, I'll multiply you in the land. You shall be blessed. You shall be multiplied. Let me read one for you. Genesis 1:22. He said that, and God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply. Be fruitful and what? Multiply. Be fruitful and multiply. Genesis 3:16-2. He said that. He says what? Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrows. I will multiply. God is speaking. So, God is a God of multiplication. God is a God of multiplication. And this kingdom, he multiply his things for us. But there are laws that govern multiplication. So that is what I want to teach you. Anything that you have in this kingdom, you can multiply it. It's a very powerful news. You can multiply it. Anything that you have, you can multiply it. You can multiply it. So I want to talk to you about how to multiply your money. Money is something that is very, very important. Everybody need money. And is a very powerful thing that without it, you can never live here on this earth. You can never live here on this earth. But before that, I want to get out some misconceptions about money. There are so many misconceptions about money. I want to first of all get it out of your mind. So many heresies about money. You see, so many people think that God is not interested in money. God is not even doesn't want them to have in more money or enough money. So because they think that when you get more money, you'll be proud. God doesn't give his people more money. All these things are not there in the Bible. All these things, they are doctrines of demons. Money is good. Bible says money answered all things. Money is a blessing of God. You understand? It is a blessing of God. It is a medium of exchange. And God said, I have blessed you with all spiritual blessings, including prosperity, financial prosperity. Financial prosperity is God's will for your life. So first of all, before you can multiply your money, you have to accept and believe that financial prosperity is God's will for your life. Financial prosperity or financial abundance or having enough money is God's will for your life. It's God's will for your life. It's God's will for your life. Now, when you read the book of 3 John 1, 2, you say, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in good health. Prosper and be in good health. He was talking about financial prosperity. So God said that he wills that you prosper and you be in good health. So prosperity, financial prosperity is God's blessing, is the way of God for your life. And Christianity is all about the way of God. Jesus Christ said that when you pray, say, our Father that art in heaven, that will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So we are supposed to pray the way of God. If it is the way of God, then God will grant it. We don't have any right to pray for anything that is not in line with the way of God. 1 John said that when we pray according to his will, he will hear us. When we pray according to his will. So if it is the way of God, then we have the right to us to pray for it and receive it. Financial prosperity, it is a way of God. Financial prosperity is a way of God. And God hates poverty. When you read Psalm 35 verse 27, Psalm 35 verse 27, he said that God takes pleasure in the prosperity of his word, of his servant. God takes pleasure in the prosperity. This scripture is very, 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 very powerful. I want you to write all of them down. And after this broadcast, go and check them. Let them shout for joy and glad and be glad. And that favor my righteous cause. Yeah, let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified, which had pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. Which had pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. This one is talking about financial prosperity. So God said that I take pleasure
in the prosperity of my servant. I take pleasure. Do you understand the word pleasure? Pleasure is excitement, joy, happiness. So God said that I become happy, I become joyous when I see my children prospering, my servant prospering. Prosperity brings me joy. Your prosperity brings me joy. Your financial prosperity brings me what? Joy. You understand? That is one of the... I want to give you enough scripture so that you know. Christianity is all about the mind. It's about knowledge. Knowledge is of the mind. And so many people have, wrong concept about God. And when you have wrong concept about God, it will affect how you relate to Him and what you receive from Him. So many people have wrong concept about God. They think that God is only interested in them living a holy life, a righteous life, they winning souls and doing the work of God. God is not all that interested in their finances, in their health, and in their life. No, God is a father. In the New Testament, Jesus said that when we pray, say, our Father. So in the New Testament, God is a father. And as a father, He cares. He loves His, he loves his children. He has responsibility. It is His responsibility to take care of us, to provide for us. He said, I will provide all your needs according to my riches and glory. He said, I seek the kingdom of God first, and all these things shall be added unto you. All these things, I will add them to you. Or Peter said that you are following what we will get. What are we going to get? He said that you will get houses, sisters, brothers, and hundredfold return. In this life, you will get land, sisters, and brothers, and also hundredfold return in this life and the life to come. Mark chapter 10, verse 30. So he said, God said He wants you to be blessed financially. Financial prosperity is a way of God for your life. Financial prosperity is a way, it is a pit of hell that God is not interested. God doesn't want you to get, it is a lie of the devil. They are doctrines of demons. And I don't know what is wrong with those pastors that preach about that. You understand? But don't worry. Very soon your ministry will come to an end, because the people of God, their eyes are opening. They are coming to the truth of the word of God. Some people say that the love of money is a root of all evil. No, the Bible didn't say the love of money. Is a root of all evil. Money is a root of all evil. He said the love of money is a root of all evil. He didn't say money is a root of all evil. Yeah. So the love of it being covetous. That is what God was talking about. Money having you, money ruling over you, money being your God is what God was talking about. And was not talking about money. Money is not evil. What you do with it that makes it evil or good. So money itself is not evil. The love of it, being covetous. Bible says that Jesus said that don't be careful of covetousness. Because life is not in the abundance of what a man possesses. So we should be careful of covetousness. God hates covetousness. God doesn't hate money. God doesn't have problem you having enough money, having enough cars, houses, and living good. No. He's only against money having you. When money helps you, money will now begin to control you. Money now begin to become your God. You understand? Now, money shouldn't be your God, but money should be a tool. So money in the hands of the righteous is supposed to be a tool to help the poor, a tool to expand the kingdom for evangelization, to meet the needs of people, to meet your family, the needs of your family. So money in the hands of the righteous is a tool. It's not supposed to be a god. You understand? The Bible says you can't serve God and mammon. So it's either you are serving the god of mammon, and money is your god, or you are serving the God of majesty. But when you serve the God of majesty, money will be your servant. You will rule over money. So we are supposed to rule over money. Money is supposed to be a servant to you. You're supposed to use money to do good things. You understand? So God is against covetousness, not money. God wants you to have enough money. But in this world, you can never operate well without money. Somebody said that The Bible says that the love of money is the root of all evil, but the lack of it is also the root of all evil. The lack of it, the fastest way the enemy can destroy you is preventing money from you. The fastest way the enemy can destroy you is to get you poor. To get you poor is to get you what? Poor. The Bible makes a certain statement over here. Proverbs chapter 10, verse 15. Proverbs chapter 10. I want you to check this scripture. It's a very, very powerful scripture. Proverbs chapter 10, verse 15. It says that the rich man's wealth is a strong city. It's a strong city. The destruction of the poor is their poverty. The destruction of the poor is their poverty. The rich man's wealth is his strong city. But the destruction of the poor is their poverty. The destruction of the poor is his poverty. So he's saying that poverty can destroy you. Poverty destroy the poor. But the rich man's wealth is his his strong city. So the fastest way the enemy can destroy you is to get you poor. Poverty has destroyed so many lives, even more than gang and bomb and sickness and disease, even viral coronavirus. Poverty is a plague, is a disease. You are supposed to hate poverty with passion. God is against poverty. God told his people in Deuteronomy 15:4, he said that there shall not be no poor among you, for the Lord shall greatly bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God has given thee for thy inheritance. The Lord, there shall be no poor among you. Deuteronomy chapter 15, verse 4. Deuteronomy chapter 15, verse 4. There shall not be poor among you. There shall not be poor among you. There shall not be poor among you. When the church also started in the book of Acts, let me read it for you. It also says that none of them were lacking. None of them were lacking. The book of Acts chapter 5, thereabouts, said none of them were lacking. So God is against lack and poverty. Poverty can destroy you. Poverty can render you ineffective, can get you mad. You become so embittered. Become so jealous. Even when people are poor, when you see others prosper, you become embittered and jealous. You can't even laugh. You can't even laugh well. Oh, you are embittered. There are so many bitterness in you because you are suffering. People are prospering all over you. If you don't take a jealousy and envy and bitterness and resentfulness will enter your heart. You cannot function well. Poverty is a killer. It's a plague. You're supposed to get rid of it. Reverend Otabel says something profound. He said that if you have some strength, don't leave the devil alone. Deal with poverty. Well, poverty is even more dangerous than the devil. Reverend Otabel. Pastor Reverend Otabel. You understand? One Nigerian man said that Luke chapter 4, verse 18, he said, Jesus Christ was anointed. How God anointed Jesus Christ to preach the gospel to the poor. The first assignment of Jesus Christ is to preach to the poor. They preach the gospel to them. Another word for the gospel is good news. So the good news to the poor is prosperity. And the good news for the sick is healing. So God is not, God doesn't bring poverty to you to test you or to teach you a lesson. No. There are some teaching that God brings some poverty so that he can strengthen you, he can correct you, and it is not true. It is not scriptural. When he reads Timothy, he said that the word of God is given from the inspiration of God. 2 Timothy 3:16, and it's profitable for doctrine, for correction, for reproof, for instruction, that a man of God will be totally furnished unto good works. So the word of God, God corrects his people by his word. He instructs and rebukes and corrects by his word. He doesn't correct people by bringing poverty and lack and sickness and disease upon them. Poverty can kill you. Sickness can kill you. So many people are dead and gone because of poverty and lack. What are you talking about? So tonight, we are talking about how to multiply your money. How to multiply your money. You understand? In Samuel 23, I said, the Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. And Philippians 4:19 also said that my God will provide all your needs. So all these scriptures are there to tell you that God is interested in your prosperity. God wants you well. God wants you prosperous. God wants you prosper. Deuteronomy 8:18 said, I'll give you power to make wealth. I'll give you power to make wealth. So God said, I've given you power to make wealth. So God wants you to be wealthy. God wants you to be wealthy. 2 Corinthians 8:9 said that Jesus Christ became poor, that through his poverty you might be rich. So God, Jesus Christ became poor so that you can be rich. What Jesus Christ did on the cross is a work of exchange, a substitutionary work. He took our place so that we can take his place. So he went to hell so that we can go to heaven. He was rejected so that we can be accepted. You understand? So that we can be accepted. He took the sin so that we can take his righteousness. He became poor so that we can become rich. You understand? So what Jesus Christ did was a work of exchange. So but this Bible is saying in 2 Corinthians 8:9, write the scriptures down. Jesus became poor that through his poverty we might be rich. So Jesus Christ became poor so that you can be rich. Jesus Christ became poor so that you can know you can be poor. No. That is not the Bible. You understand? Jesus Christ, he took your infirmity so that you can live in health. That is the work of the cross. That is the substitutionary work of Jesus on the cross of Calvary. Another scripture, very powerful scriptures. 1 Timothy 5:8. Write it down for those people. That is for the husbands. Very powerful. He said that if anyone cannot provide for the family, if you cannot provide for your family, that is 5:8. He said that but if any provide not for his own and especially for those of his own house, he had denied the faith and is worse than infidel. He was talking about the husband. That if you can't provide for your family, if you can't provide for your wife, for your children, you have denied the faith. You are worse than infidel. The wonderful word for infidel is an unbeliever. So God is saying that if you can't provide for your family, if you are your husband and you are watching me and you can't provide for your family, you can't pay school fees, you can't feed your children, you can't give them good clothes, a good shelter, you have denied the faith. You are worse than infidel. That is what the scripture is saying. So God is against poverty. You understand? God is not interested in you becoming lack. No, it doesn't glorify him. He is a king. And what glorifies a king is that his people will live a quality life. The quality of the life of the people is what brings glory to the king. He is a king of kings. No, if you are shattered, you are always poor, lack, you are always struggling. No, it doesn't bring glory to God. It's about time that we renew our mind. Until our minds are renewed, we can never mount to anything. You can never have a poverty mindset and pray for prosperity, prosperous life. No, it will not work. You can never have a negative mindset and pray for a positive life. Bible says, as a man thinketh, so it all starts from the mind. You have to change your mind. Bible says in Romans chapter 12, verse 1, go in the domain, conform to this, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you'll be able to approve the good, the perfect, and acceptable way of God. Approve. Another word for approve is experience. So for you to experience the good, the perfect, and acceptable way of God, the mind needs to be renewed. It must be renewed concerning who you are, what God has done for you, what Jesus Christ did on the cross. One of the things that Jesus Christ did for you, gave it to you, is prosperity. It's part of salvation. It's part of salvation. Salvation is not about receiving forgiveness and receiving the life of God. It's also prosperity, wholeness, soundness. The word is soteria. Everything is inclusive. All the blessing of God is embedded in that word, salvation. You understand? Prosperity is part of salvation. Prosperity, wealth, riches is part of salvation. It is your right. Prosperity is your right. As a child of God, you have the right to provision. You have the right to supernatural provision. God is your father. And as a father, it is his responsibility to take care of you, to provide for you. He said, I have provided for you. But you need to receive it by faith. And faith is knowledge. And knowledge is of the mind. So the mind needs to be renewed concerning God's system of financial abundance. That God is a God of systems and laws. There are systems that govern his financial prosperity. That is what we are talking about. God wants you prosperous, but there are principles. There are principles that govern His kingdom. His sanity is about God and His principles, about Jesus and His laws. But we are in the kingdom, and we don't know the principles that govern the kingdom, that governs the kingdom. There are principles that govern marriage. There are principles that govern the supernatural. There are principles that govern operation of the spirit. There are principles that govern hell. There are principles that govern injury. There are principles that govern the anointing, the power of God, prosperity. There are principles that govern all these things. So if you don't know, if you don't cooperate with those principles, it will not work. They are laws. Laws are universal and constant. It works everywhere. It's like the law of gravity is working in Asia, America, wherever you are, it will work. If you put it, if you apply it, it will work. So the word of God works. It's a law of God. God said, I will not utter my word. My word will never come and return unto me void or empty. When you put them into practice, it will work. You understand? It will work. So, yeah, let's move on now. Oh, the next one is you have to develop the consciousness that God the Father is your source. Is your source. God, you have to develop the consciousness that God the Father is your source. Jesus said that the lilies of the field, they don't work, they don't do anything. They don't sow, they don't spend. But your Heavenly Father feeded them the best of the air. And your Heavenly Father feeded them. Are you not better than they? Are you not better than they? Solomon in all his glory cannot be arrayed like these lilies of the field. So he was saying that the lilies of the field, they are richer than Solomon, the richest person. But God is the one who is taking care of them. You are a human being. You are made in the image and the likeness of God. So God said that, are you not better than they, ye men of little faith? So all these things about faith. It's about faith. It's about faith. God wants you well. Deuteronomy 1:19 said that if you be willing and obedient, you will enjoy the good of the land. The best of the land is yours. The best clothes, the best house, the best cars, the best food, the best perfume, the best things are yours. It's if you be willing and obedient, you enjoy the best of the land. Isaiah 1:19. That is the word of God. Isaiah 1:19. So, develop the consciousness that God is a father. God is your source. He's a father. The word is pater, your source and substance. So, he's your father. You go to him, anything that you need, you ask him. He said he will provide all your needs. Philippians 4:9, all your needs, according to his riches and glory. All your needs, not some needs. All your needs, doesn't matter. There's nothing that God cannot provide. He's a maker of the heaven and the earth. The silver and the gold belong to him. He said, thousands of the cattle on the hills belong to me, saith the Lord. The earth is of the Lord, the fullness thereof, and the word they that dwell therein belong to me. Thousands of the cattle of hills belong to me. The silver and the gold belong to me, saith the Lord. There's nothing that God cannot give it. He said, all that I have is thine. All that I have is thine. You are a child of God. Everything that belongs to God belongs to you. Everything that belongs to God belongs to you. You are a child of God. You are entitled to inheritance. You are entitled to inheritance. That is why Jesus Christ came to what? Die for you. He came to restore anything that be lost to you. Now, so many people believe that when Adam committed disobedience, we lost everything. But few of us believe that now when Jesus Christ died, everything is restored. Now, the God of multiplication, that is the system of multiplication. So the God that we serve is a God of multiplication. And the God that we serve is a God of multiplication. Now, this God that we serve is also the God of his part and our part. He's a God of his part and our part. In other words, anything that God wants to do for you, he will do his part and we will also do our part. But most of the times, we don't do our part. I mean, we even try to go and do God's part for him. You can't do God's part. No, he can only do his part, but you have to also do your part. And because he's a faithful God, he will always do his part. Your part is to ask, he will give. Your part is to what? Lay hands, the sick will be healed. Your part is to command the sick, the demon to go, and he will make sure that it will go. You understand? So we always have our part to play. Now, for God to multiply your money, what are you supposed to do? For God to multiply your money, what are you supposed to do? First of all, in the spirit where money is a seed. In the spirit word, 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 money is a seed. That is Second Corinthians 9. In the spirit word, money is a seed. 2 Corinthians 9. So you have to see that money is a seed. It's a seed. Now when you read 2 Corinthians 9:6, but I say he that soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Every man according as he has purpose in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. It God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that is, he always having all sufficiency in all things may abound unto every good word. Now, and as is written, he that dispersed abroad, he had given to the poor, his righteousness remaining forever. Now he that ministers seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food, and multiply your seed sown, and increase the fruit of your righteousness. Now he that ministers seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food, and multiply your seed sown. Multiply your seed sown. Now 2 Corinthians 8:9-10 talks about money. Take time and go and read. It talks about money. Paul was telling them about money, giving what they should give according to how God has blessed them and all that. If you sow bountifully, you reap bountifully. If you sow sparingly, you reap sparingly. So he said that God will give you seed. He that ministers seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food. Now he said that for God to multiply your money, first of all, you have to see that money is a seed in the spirit realm. Now, when we all know that when you eat your seed, you have also eaten your harvest. You understand? So any money that you receive, there's a seed part and there's also a bread part. You understand? So you eat some, then you sow some. You understand? You use some, then also you sow some. You use some by investing, or you spend some, then you also sow some. You understand? So when you sow it, then God said that he will multiply your seed sown. That is 1 Corinthians 9:10. He will multiply your seed or sown. The word is sown. He will multiply your seed sown. So he will not just multiply your seed. The word is not multiply. You don't just multiply. He will only multiply your seed sown. The seed that you have sown is what you will multiply. And Genesis 8:22 says that as long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest shall not cease. As long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest shall not cease. While the earth remains, seed time and harvest, and cold and heat, and summer and winter, and day and night shall not cease. So God is saying that as long as this earth remains, seed time and harvest, they will not cease. So this earth is still there. So seed time, the word is all about seed and harvest. Seed and harvest. Everything that you see is seed. Human beings were once a seed. You understand? All these trees that you see, they are seed. You understand? So the life is all about sowing and reaping. It's about seed and harvest. But you have to sow the seed. When the moment you hear seed, the moment you hear sow, it connotes a seed and also soil. Because if you don't sow your seed, you cannot harvest. You understand? And God is saying that money is also what? A seed. So how to multiply your money is that you sow the money. The money that come to your hand, you sow some. Now, when we talk about sowing, we also talk about soil, because you can't just sow your seed. And no good farmer will just be going about sowing seed to the gutters and to, roadside, rocky. No. There's a right soil for every seed. There's a right soil for every seed. And there's time to also for you to sow. You must know the time for every particular seed. You must know all that. You understand? So God is saying that He will multiply your seed soon. So where do you sow? Now we know that money is a seed. In the spirit world, money is a seed. So when you get money, don't consume all of them. Don't consume all of them. Don't consume all of them. And we are not also saying that sow all your money. You can invest some, you can also use some, but even if you invest some, you must still have to also give. Because I have seen some people, they invested their money and they lost all of them. When you sow some of your money to the right place, God will make sure that your investment will not lose your investment. He will increase your investment, he will multiply them. The blessing of God will come upon you. God said that when you sow yours, I will multiply your seed soon. I'll multiply it. So first of all, you must find out the right soil. How do you find the right soil? The right soil here has something to do with the recipient. Where the money is going is what we call the soil. Where the money is going. Now, as children of God, as Christians, this is a place that we are supposed to sow. This is a spiritual fertile soil. I'm going to teach you. Just take note. You don't just go and sow. It is possible to sow and not reap. Because if you don't sow it at the right place, it will not even germinate. You can't just throw your seed into the gutter. You understand? You can't just throw your seed on the road where there is full of stones. No. It will not germinate. Jesus Christ gave a parable that a seed went to sow. Some fell on the roadside, some in a rocky place. And he said that the one that fell on the good soil was one that brought some harvest, 60, 30, and what have you. So you need a right soil to sow your seed. Now, these are the right soil. The kingdom project. You must sow into the kingdom project. Kingdom projects like building a church and crusade and evangelism trip, outreach program, the kingdom project. Kingdom project. Those people, when you sow into such project, God will multiply by because when you sow it, you have given to God, and God is the richest person in the whole world, and you cannot give it to God and not God giving it to you back. Giving is all about the secret behind giving is all about God taking what you have and multiplying it back to you. So say he will multiply your seed soon. He will multiply your seed what soon. So when you give it to Kingdom Project, God will give it to you back because you have given to the richest person in the whole world. And when you give it to God and he doesn't give it to you back, you are telling God that you are faithful than God. You are more generous than God. There's nobody that is more generous than God. He's the most generous and the richest person in the entire universe. And you can never outgive God. You can never give to God and not God giving to you back multiplied. No. He said he will multiply it back and give it to you. Bible says in Genesis, Luke chapter 6, verse 6, give and shall be given into good measure, pressed down, shaking together, running over, shall men give unto your bosom. Good measure, pressed down, shaking together, shall men give unto your bosom. In Proverbs chapter 11, verse 24, he said, He that scattereth increaseth, but he that withhold tend to poverty. When you scatter your seed, you will increase. So the law of increase is a law of release. The law of increase is a law of release. So when you scatter your seed, you will increase. The Bible says, when you give, it shall be given unto you. Galatians chapter 6, verse 7, so whatsoever a man sows, so shall he reap. When you sow into the flesh, you will reap of corruption. When you sow into the spirit, you will reap eternal life. So there's no way that when you sow to the right place, you will not reap back. No. So you sow into kingdom project and assignment, kingdom project and kingdom assignment, missions, conferences, Christian conferences, radio and TV Christian programs, church building, I've said it, crusade, conventions, camp meetings, you sow into them. You also sow, another one is also the poor, you must also give it to the poor. You must also give it to the poor. Bible says, he that giveth to the poor shall not what? Lack. He that giveth to the poor shall not lack. Psalm 41 verse 1. So we are supposed to give to the poor. Supposed to give to the poor, the needy. Psalm 41 verse 1. You see, blessed is he that consider the poor. The Lord will deliver him in time of trouble. The Lord will deliver him. When you consider the poor, the Lord will deliver you in time of poor. So we are supposed to take care of the poor. God is always concerned about the poor. God wants us to take care of the poor. Those people that are rich, consider the poor. God said, consider the poor. Don't be stingy. Consider the poor. Don't be armstrong. And the blessings of God's system is that he will bless you so that you'll be a blessing. So when God blesses you and you hoard it, you heap it up, you kind of substitute the blessing, you cut the flow. So the system, God's system of blessing is that God's system of financial prosperity is that he will bless you, that you'll be a blessing. He said that Abraham, I will bless you so that you'll be a blessing. So until you are a blessing, you are not really blessed of God. Until you are a blessing, you are not really blessed of God. So we are supposed to consider the poor. Psalm 112 verse 9. We are supposed to consider the poor. Psalm 112 verse 9. He said that he that disperses, he had given to the poor, his righteousness endureth forever, his horn shall be exalted with honor. He has given to the poor, his horn shall be exalted forever, his righteousness endureth forever. He has given to the poor, he has dispersed, and had given to the poor, his righteousness shall be endureth forever, his horn shall be exalted, his horn shall be exalted, his horn shall be exalted. So we are supposed to give to the poor. That is also a good soil. Make sure that the person is in need. You understand? So people, they can fake it and bring, go deep and set, investigate. Make sure that the person is really in need. You understand? Then you support him. Bible says that when your brother comes to you for help and you have the power to help, don't say you should go. You should go and come. No. Help your brother. Jesus said that, give to everyone that asks you. Be generous. Don't be stingy, my brother. What is wrong with you? Don't be stingy. Don't be stingy. You are too stingy. You are too armstrong. Repent. 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 If you don't repent, you will lose your money. That is the word of God. If you don't consider the poor, the Lord will not also remember you in the days of trouble. And trouble will come. Troubles are in the world. You understand? Then the next one is that the prophet. The prophet, that is the man of God or the woman of God. There's something called the reward of the prophet. The reward of the prophet. The reward of the prophet. That is Matthew 10:41. Every man of God has some kind of anointing upon his life or her life. Now, the fastest way to provoke the anointing upon a man of God's life is the what? Is to give it to him. When you give it to an anointed man of God like me, God said that you will receive the reward of the prophet. The reward of the prophet is that when the prophet or the man of God speaks, it will come to pass. It will come to pass. When you provoke the anointing upon a man of God and he speaks over your life, he pray for you, it will come to pass. He that receiveth a prophet in the name of a prophet shall receive a prophet reward. Shall receive a prophet reward. So many people has received a prophet reward. And because of the prophet reward, they are rich now. I learned the richest man in Africa, Dangote, Idahosa prayed for him. He did something good for Idahosa, and Idahosa prayed for him. And just one prayer, this man is one of the richest. He's the richest man in Africa. I learned also Bishop Oyedepo, who's the richest man of God, also so into Idahosa. He also prayed for me. Most of the richest Christians, They sow some seed to a church or some man of God, whatever. Oh, if you want to prosper, don't be stingy. You have to give. You have to give. The fastest way to get out of poverty is to give what you have. Say, God, I give you my poverty. Take take and give me your prosperity. Lord, take this seed and meet my need. God's system of taking people out of spiritual poverty and famine is that they give. In times of need, you have to give. You have to give. When Jesus Christ had to take away the 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes and multiply it, you have to take it. You understand? Have to take it. The Elijah too also took the widow's meal. You have to take the food, and after eating it, he prayed for the woman, and see what happened. So that is God's system. Anytime God wants to perform a miracle, He takes what you have, what you have. But human beings, we find it difficult to give it, especially when things are when we are in need. Especially this time that so many people things are not really well. This is the time you're supposed to give. You're supposed to release what you have. When you release it, God will also multiply it back to you. God will multiply it. So one of the good soil is sowing to the man of God's life. The man of God who is also in line with the word of God. He is preaching the gospel. You understand? He's preaching the gospel. How do you know that the man of God is genuine? A man of God that preaches the gospel. Why we say that he that is called of God preaches the word of God. So if the man of God is really genuine, he will preach the word of God. Not be talking a prophecy and selling things and all that. You know, he preached the word. And we are supposed to preach the word. One of the signs that shows that a man or woman of God is from God, the man or the woman is from God, is that he preaches the word of God, the unadulterated word of God, the infallible word of God. He preaches the word. He preaches the word. And another one is that he bear fruit. He bear fruit. Every good tree bear fruit. And I say he must bear the fruit of the Spirit. That is love, joy, peace, humility, meekness, self-control. You must check the fruit. You don't check the gift. Don't check the gift. Even Satan is gifted. Satan is anointed. But Satan cannot bear fruit. So if you want to see that a man of God, you should check the fruit. Check the fruit. Check his self-control. Check his love, how he treats people, and his mannerism and all that. His love life and his humility and all that, meekness and goodness. Check all of them. You understand? That is what you will see, that this man is a man of God. It's by their fruit he shall know them. By their fruit he shall know them, and they will also preach the word of God. They are always also after, souls, and they are conscious of the kingdom, building the kingdom, discipleship, and soul winning, and all that. It's a kingdom-minded. It's a kingdom-minded. So into such ministries. Especially in my ministry, there are so many things that I'm doing. I want to open a Bible, so I want to also do some conferences and do so many things, crusade and all that. Open churches, you can sow into this ministry, word creation ministry, you can sow into this, and I bet you will see a miracle. And I pray for so many people and they have received miracle. I'm telling you, I have been in a ministry for over 20 years now. I have seen so many things. And I suggest that some of the people are not grateful, very ungrateful people. You understand? It's not good. Bible says that those that communicate the word, they must also be communicated to. And those that also preach the word must receive a double honor. Paul said that when I give you spiritual blessing, you must also minister to me material blessing. It is a divine essence. When you do that, you'll be blessed. Don't be receiving blessing from a ministry and you don't sow into it. No. That is how God has made it, that his people will give to this kingdom, to their kingdoms, and God will also bless them. That is how God has ordained it. I was reading Ben Hinn and said that he wrote to financial blessing, said that God told him that the reason why his people are struggling is that they are not giving to the kingdom. If they give it to the kingdom, he will also cause them the wealth of the wicked to come to them. So from today, change your mindset. Yeah. I think I've finished. Yeah, so how do you, after sowing what? You water your seed. You water. How do you water? Ephesians chapter 5 verse 26. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 26. After seed, after sowing, you water. You don't just sow and you leave the seed. Just water your seed. How do you water your seed? Ephesians chapter 5 verse 26. He said that that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word. So the word of God is also the water. So how do you water? You water it by speaking the word of God over it. You speak the promises of God. You said that when you give, it shall be given unto us. You said that when we sow, we will reap. You said that when we give, you will give unto us good measure, pressed down. Father, thank you for honoring your word. Thank you for bountiful harvest. So you remember God. We put God in remembrance of his word. Then you also give thanks. You also give thanks. When you give, you also expect. You understand? People say that when you give, you don't have to expect. No, it's wrong. You see, give and shall be given unto you good measure. Paul said that you people, Philippians, you have communicated with me. Only you people communicated to me with giving and receiving. Giving and what? Receiving. Giving and what? Receiving. Giving and receiving. Giving and what? Receiving. So it is not giving. It is not giving. It is giving and what? Receiving. Giving and receiving. So you water your seed by speaking the word of God. Speaking the word of God. Bible said, I Paul planted, Apollo watered. Apollo watered by also teaching. So we water by the word of God, by speaking the word of God. You understand? So we speak the word of God, and also one another way to also pray in the spirit. When you pray in the spirit, the spirit of God also symbolizes water. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we also pray more in the spirit. When you sow, you pray more in the spirit, then you give thanks. We thank God for the harvest. You bless him for the harvest. You thank him for the harvest. Thank you for the harvest. You praise him for the harvest. So you water your seed with much praise and thanksgiving. Then you also, put God in remembrance of his word concerning. The harvest, when we give, it shall be given unto us. When we give it to him, he will give it to us back. He will multiply it back to us. Then the last one is that you receive it by faith. The next one is expect. Expect. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 14 says, the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. So our expectation will not be cut off. Our expectation is your faith. The greater the expectation, the stronger your faith. And the stronger the faith, the faster the manifestation. So after giving, you have to expect. Be in a state of expectancy. Be expecting the harvest. Whatever you are, be expecting when God are coming. Be expecting. Be in a state of expectancy. So many people, after giving, they don't expect. The second one is expect. Be expect that God will give it to you. God said that he will give it to you. Good measure, press down, seeking together, running over. So, man, give unto your bosom. When you sow, you will also reap. If you sow bountifully, you also reap bountifully. There are some money that you have to sow bountifully. You understand? And the amount you also count. There are some harvest you can't get it with small seed. Sometimes you have to increase your seed, but you start it from small. Then as the harvest is coming, you are giving more. The more you give, the more you harvest. The law of sowing and reaping say that whatever you sow, you will reap it, and you will reap more than what you have sown. And the more you sow, the more you reap. That is the law of sowing and reaping. So you determine what you receive, what you get. If what you are getting is not enough for you, you increase your seed. You increase your seed. You increase it till you get a harvest that is enough. And in this kingdom, when you also have something that is not enough to meet your need, it's a seed money. Give it out for God to give you a harvest money that is enough to meet your need. Like you need some laptop and the money that you have is not enough. You give it away for God to give you enough money to buy the laptop. That is this kingdom. Yeah. So the final one is that you receive it by faith. Bible says we walk by faith, not by sight. We walk by faith, not by sight. Bible says in Mark 11:24 that we should whenever we desire, when we pray, we should believe that we have received. So we receive in this kingdom by faith. And faith has nothing to do with sight. So you don't have to look at things. You don't have to check. No. Most times when after giving or after prayer and fasting, things become difficult. Why? Because it is a work of the enemy. The enemy wants to use it to trick you and get you out of faith. So after giving, you don't have to look. You don't have to work by sight. Don't look at the circumstances. Things might be hard, but don't worry. God is working behind the scene. So we receive by faith. You walk by faith You fight the fight of faith till the harvest manifest. Don't look at the circumstances. Don't look at the circumstances. Faith has nothing to do with the sight. Irrespective of the sensory perception, your faith is working. Your harvest is coming. God is working behind the scene. Don't look at the circumstances. If you want to see that, if you want to use the physical evidence to see that God is working, then you will miss God. God is a faith God. Faith has nothing to do with the sight. It is strictly the word of God. You understand? So God has said that he will give you harvest. He will multiply it back. So you believe it, irrespective of the contradictory circumstances. So hold on to the word of God and confess the word of God, the promise of God's word, and also give thanks. Then it will manifest. So you receive it by faith in your heart. Then you expect the manifestation. Then you give thanks. And not forgetting diligent. Diligent and also diligent. The Bible says in Proverbs 10:4, the Bible says a diligent hand make it rule. You are supposed to be also diligent. Somebody will ask, is that the only way to multiply your money? No. But also diligent, also hard work, faithfulness, honesty, and all that is also will multiply your money. But even if you are diligent, you are faithful, and you are honest, and you are hard work. A hard worker, you still have to give. You understand? You have to give all kinds of giving. Tithing, first fruit, giving to a man of God, giving to church. You have to give all of them. Almsgiving. Do all the different kinds of the giving that God has given to us. Give all of them. So we are not also downgrading the diligence and faithfulness and honesty. And also don't be covetous. Don't be jealous and envious. Yeah, when God is blessing your people, your friend, or one, don't be jealous. Don't be boiled over with jealousy. What do you envy about? You will not attract it. You understand? Be happy for your brother when he is being blessed. Be happy for him. Be happy for her. Don't be jealous and don't be envious. And also set your priority right. Bible says seek the kingdom of God first. Now some people, when God begin to bless them, they begin to behave funny, become so materialistic, use the money for necessary things, and they don't even support the kingdom. Set your priority right, the kingdom first, your family, then also the needy. You understand? God blesses us so that we will feed our family. God blesses us for the kingdom. God blesses us so that we can support ourselves. So use the word of God for the right thing. There's a purpose for God's prosperity, financial prosperity and wealth. Don't use the wealth of God for different purposes. You will block the flow. You will block the flow. So set your priority right. The kingdom first. The kingdom first. The kingdom what first? Yeah. So God bless you. This briefly how to multiply your money. Yeah. How to multiply? If you want to talk to me, if you have a problem, I'm a prophet. I'm also a healing minister. If you have problem with any part of your body, or you know somebody who is sick or also suffering from addiction and all kind of demonic manipulation or occultic manipulation, if you are an occultic pastor, you want to change, you can call me. We have been given power to set the captive free. We have the anointing to heal the sick. So my number is +2 3347 +2 3347 662 182 +2 3347 662 182. If you are in Ghana here, is 0247 662 182 0247 662 182. Yeah, you can also call me through WhatsApp, or you can inbox me. You can also get me through Facebook, Alex Anointio. Alex Anointio. Yeah, God bless you. I want to pray for you. Father, I pray for your people. I bless you. I thank you for the preaching of your word. I ask that you will minister to your people. I pray that as many people that are under the sound of my voice, let this word be established in their mind and their heart. Let this word be written upon the tablets of their heart. I pray that they will not be forgetful hearers, but they will be doers of the word. In the name of Jesus, Father, it is your will that we prosper and be in good health. It is your will that we live in
abundance, that we have more than enough to give and to do your will. I pray that this move that you're about to release will affect your people. In the name of Jesus, the financial prosperity move, I pray that it will affect them. I break the spirit of poverty upon your people. Every spirit of lack and want, I break your power. Break in the name of Jesus. Break loose now the spirit of poverty. I cast you out in Jesus' name. I break your power. Loose your grip in Jesus' name. Now I speak to your businesses and your work. Now, from today, you will prosper. You will increase. You will advance. In the name of Jesus, I release the spirit of prosperity and wealth upon you. In the name of Jesus, may you prosper and be in good health. May you excel. May you succeed in the name of Jesus. Any money that belongs to you, but the enemy is preventing it, I break it loose in Jesus' name. I release your destiny helpers in the name of Jesus. I command the angels of prosperity to go forth and cause the necessary finances that you need in Jesus' name. May the Lord meet you at the point of your need in the name of Jesus. May the great provider come through for you in Jesus' name. As many people that are believing God for financial miracle, I release your miracle in Jesus' name. Release your miracle in Jesus' name. I thank God for your life. As many people that I want to also support the ministry of God, I loose you to give in Jesus' name. Any money that you were expecting, I command that money to be released now in Jesus' name. I lose that money in Jesus' name. Satan, take off your hands from the finances of the people of God in Jesus' name. Break the power, lose your grip in Jesus' name. Break loose now. I set your finances free in the name of Jesus. I command all kinds of currencies into your bank account, into your wallet, into your bank. I command cedis, pounds, dollars, euros, naira, sifa, yen. Command them into your hands, into your bank account in thousands, in millions. In Jesus' name, I can release them all. In Jesus' name. Good of her, CD verse. Brakaduza Makabuza. Bantam, Brantam, Dantam, Tam. Kappa, Kasa, Tata, Kosa. Kopa, Bini, Bibosa. In the name of Jesus, thank God for your life. In the name of Jesus, you will prosper and be in good health. In the name of Jesus, as many people that are sick in every part of their body, I curse disease to leave your body. In Jesus' name, be healed from the crown of your head to the source of your feet. In Jesus' name, I command the healing power of God to effect cure and health now. In Jesus' name, be healed in your bones, be cleansed in your blood, be healed in your tissues. In the name of Jesus, every part of your body, I command it to begin to function perfectly. In Jesus' name, healing belongs to you by stripes. You are healed. Be healed now. In Jesus' name, be healed now. In Jesus' name, I break the power of addiction. Nicotine, drugs, I break the power of addiction over your life in Jesus' name. Be free now, in Jesus' name. Be free now, in the name of Jesus. I set you free today, in the name of Jesus. I set you free to serve God in Jesus' name. I pray every demon I shine against you, manipulation, occult manipulation, I break their power in Jesus' name. I set you from every witchcraft attack, generational curses, break loose now in Jesus' name. Thank God for your life in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, thank God for your life. You are free. In Jesus' precious name. If the Son of God said to you, you are free indeed. In the name of Jesus. If you want to accept Jesus Christ, the Lord, the person said, if you are not born again, you are not part of what I said. If you are not part, be part of it. Jesus Christ is coming. You need to give your life to Jesus Christ. God loves you. God is ready to forgive all your sins. Let's pray after me. Say, Father, I come as I am. You said that when I come, you know why cast me out. Accept me as your son, as your daughter. Forgive me of all my sins. And also write my name in the book of life. Give me your Holy Spirit to live for you. Strengthen me to live for you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for making me born again. I'm a new creation. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for saving me. I'm born again. In Jesus' name. Yeah, you can write me and send me a message through my WhatsApp line. You can also call me. As I told you, I'm Apostle Alexander Boakye Anointing. I live in Ghana. Yeah, it doesn't matter wherever you are. If you want to invite me, if you are a pastor, if you are also to Bible school, I also teach in Bible schools. I'm a topical Bible preacher, a teacher. Yeah, so you can also invite me. You want to invite me for conference, for revival, crusade, whatever. You can invite me. You are free. You can write me. Let's talk. Yeah, if you're also sick in every part of your body, call me. If I'm believing God for the fruit of the womb, call me. Yeah, if you also want to talk to me about something, no problem. You are all of you are invited. God bless you. May the Lord be with you. Subscribe to this channel, Elohai TV, and also invite friends, and also share it to friends and family. Let them be a blessed. Bible says that the gospel was preached, by great was the company of them that published it. Be part of the great ones that will publish this message. God will bless you. Help us spread the gospel in the name of Jesus. If you also want to support me, yeah, take my number and also write me. I'll tell you how to support. Just support this ministry. Your life will never be the same. You can never outgive God. When you give, God will give back to you. Just prove God with your substance. Bible says, prove here with me, with your offerings and with your substance. And see if I will not open the windows of heaven for you and bless you. You now have enough blessing. Support us. There are so many things that we want to do. We need your support. God will bless you for supporting us. In the name of Jesus, bless you. Thank God for your life. In Jesus' precious name, amen.